Good morning, everyone. So in the last previous class, I have discussed about what do you mean by absorption of drugs and what is the most important step after oral administration. That is nothing but absorption. So after oral administration of every drug, compulsory there will be a absorption process, which is a very prerequisite step. So here we are having different mechanisms for the absorption of drugs. So these are all the different types of mechanisms where the drug can be absorbed through any of these mechanisms. Among all the mechanisms, partial diffusion is very important. So passive diffusion is very important process. Coming to the first mechanism, that is passive diffusion. So this passive diffusion is also having another name, that is called as non-ionic diffusion. What do you mean by ionic and non-ionic? Ionic means it is having some charge. Non-ionic means it will not get ionized. So that's why passive diffusion is also called as non-ionic diffusion. Generally, maximum amount of the drugs get passed through the membrane, the drugs which are having unionized form. When compared to the ionized form, unionized form of the drugs can rapidly cross the membrane 3 to 4 times more rapidly when compared with the ionic form of the drugs. So among all the different mechanisms, if you take the passive diffusion, almost 90% of the drugs get absorbed through the passive diffusion. So here the driving force of this passive diffusion is either electrochemical gradient or concentration gradient. Either electrochemical gradient or concentration gradient. Most 90% of the drugs get administered through the passive diffusion. So compared with all the other mechanisms for the absorption of drugs, so the passive diffusion is having a high importance. Next. So what do you mean by this concentration gradient? It is nothing but it is defined as a difference in the drug concentration on the either side of the membrane. We are having one membrane. So after oral administration of the drug enters into our body, and then we are having different biological membranes. So any drug should show the pharmacological effect in the systemic circulation. Means first of all, it should cross the biological membrane. So this biological membrane acts as a barrier. If you take the biological membrane as a barrier, this outer side and the inner side of the membrane, we are checking the concentration difference. If the concentration on the either side of the membrane will become equilibrium, the absorption process will get stopped. So that is the concentration equilibrium. So the drug will get passed through the membrane until the equilibrium is attained. So this is the difference in the concentration gradient of the membrane on the either side. If the on the either side of the membrane, if the concentration becomes equal, then the concentration of the drug will get stopped. So when the inside drug concentration will get swept away and distributed to all the organs, the remaining portion of the drug get entered again, crosses the biological membrane until equilibrium is attained. After again, it will get distributes to all the organs. So in this way, the complete drug absorption will be occurred. So in this passive diffusion, no energy expenditure is required. Means there is no need to get the external energy for the mechanism of the drug or for the absorption of the drug. So since there is no energy source is required, that's why it is calling as passive diffusion. Okay. So during this passive diffusion, first of all, I have told you just right now, during passive diffusion, the drug present in the aqueous solution means, first of all, after the administration of, if you take the tablet or capsule, after the administration of the tablet, what will happen, either the tablet or capsule, it will get entered into our gastric fluids over there. Because of the gastric fluids, it will get disintegrated. After disintegration and after deaggregation of the tablet, it should cross the biological membrane, and then inside it will get again dissolved in the particular systemic circulation and distributes in the body. So here, during the passive diffusion, the drug present in the aqueous solution at the absorption site partitions and dissolves in the lipid material. So first of all, it should dissolve or it should disintegrate and deaggregate in the gastrointestinal fluids, which are nothing but the aqueous solution. So after disintegration, dissolution, deaggregation in the aqueous solution, then it crosses the lipid membrane. After crossing the membrane, again it should dissolve in the aqueous fluids, because only the membrane is a lipoidal one. Before and after, there will be existence of aqueous solutions. So first of all, it should disintegrate and deaggregate in the outer part of the membrane, that is in the gastrointestinal fluids. After attaining a good deaggregation, it should cross the lipoidal membrane. The lipid membrane is nothing but the oil loving material. So after crossing, again in the blood circulation or in the systemic circulation, again we are having the aqueous fluids. So over there also it should dissolve. So any drug which is we are taking, it should have both lipophilic and aqueous properties. If it is having both lipophilic and hydrophilic properties, then only it can dissolve in the gastrointestinal fluids or the aqueous fluids rapidly and can easily cross the membrane. So any drug should have amphiphilic properties, that is nothing but having both the characteristics of hydrophilic and lipophilic. Hydrophilic means everyone knows it is water loving, and lipophilic means nothing but oil loving properties. So this passive diffusion is best expressed by using fixed law of diffusion. This fixed law of first diffusion can explain in detailly about the passive diffusion. So what the fixed first law of diffusion is stating, that the concentration of the drug moves from a higher concentration to the lower concentration, which states that the drug molecule is diffused from a region of higher concentration to the lower concentration. If you take CGIT and C plasma, so among the two, CGIT is having a higher concentration, because after the administration of the drugs, the higher drug concentration will be attained here, because total 100% of the drug first reaches the CGIT. So we are having one barrier. So here the drug molecules get disintegrate and dissolve. After that, the liquid will get cross the membrane. The drug particles will cross the membrane. After the drug molecules get crossing the membrane, here we are having plasma. So compared to this, this is having the higher concentration level. So that's why the movement of drug particles from higher concentration to the lower concentration of the region. So next is attained, and the rate of diffusion is directly proportional to the concentration gradient across the membrane. Obviously, if we are having a greater concentration on the difference in the either concentration of the membrane, what will happen? The rapidity will be increased, means the absorption process will be continued. If there is a higher difference in the concentration gradient, there will be a higher absorption rate. So the passive diffusion was best expressed by fixed first law of diffusion, and it can be expressed mathematically by using this equation, that is dq by dt is equal to dak n by w by h cgit minus c. So here what do you mean by dq by dt? Nothing but the rate of drug diffusion, means how much amount of the drug was reached to the systemic circulation will be considered as dq by dt. Actually, we have to calculate this by using all these terms. So by doing the experiment, we can get all these factors. So by using that factors, we can know how much amount of the drug get diffused through the biological membrane rapidly, and how much amount of the drug was entered into the systemic circulation. So what do you mean by D? D means nothing but diffusion coefficient of the drug. What do you mean by diffusion? Everyone knows, if the drug is having both lipophilic and hydrophilic characteristics, that drug can diffuse rapidly across the membrane, and that drug can dissolve more rapidly in the blood circulation, which results in having a greater therapeutic effect. So that is the diffusion coefficient. So the drug should have both the lipophilic and hydrophilic properties. Now next, surface area. So our membrane is having a surface area. Now if the membrane surface area is high, the rate of diffusion is also high, because surface area is increasing means what will happen? The thickness will be decreased. So it may lead, obviously the surface area, if it is increasing, means having a greater exposure to the drug to diffuse rapidly. Next, Km by W. So here K means nothing but partition coefficient and membrane and water. So between the lipoidal membrane and the water, we have to check the partition coefficient. I have told you partition coefficient or diffusion means nothing but the drug should have both the lipophilic properties and hydrophilic properties. If the particular drug is having both the characteristics, it is obviously it is having a greater diffusion capacity and partition coefficient capacity. Coming to the CGIT minus C, difference in the concentration of the drug in the gastrointestinal fluids and plasma. I have told you initially the drug concentration is higher at the gastrointestinal fluids. So after that it will attain equilibrium with the plasma. So fixed first law of diffusion means nothing but higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. Obviously, first the drug, total amount of the drug should touches the gastrointestinal fluids. Over there, higher concentration levels will be maintained. So, from the gastrointestinal fluids, the drug membrane should cross the drug molecule should cross the membrane slowly and reaches the plasma. So higher concentration to the lower concentration. So if a particular drug is following sink conditions, every time the GIT is having a higher concentration when compared to the plasma. H means nothing but the thickness of the membrane. If the surface area is increasing, the thickness will be decreased. If the surface area is increasing, the absorption capacity will be increased, and the thickness is also decreasing means if it is having a lesser thickness, the absorption is more rapid. So based on the above equation, the passive diffusion can be generalized with the following points. First one, the drug moves down the concentration gradient, indicating the downhill transport. What the fixed first law of diffusion indicating? Region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. So it is moving down, that's why it is calling as downhill transport. The rate of drug transfer is directly proportional to the concentration gradient. I have told you if the concentration is higher, the drug concentration is higher, there will be a rapid transfer of the membrane. So if, for example, if I am taking 50 mg of drug initially, so among the 50 mg of drug, 25 mg of the drug get crossed to the biological membrane. So equilibrium is attained. So after equilibrium is attained, the other 25 mg will not get crossed because there will be equilibrium. So this 25 mg then should distribute entirely in the body organs or the body tissues. So after swept away of this 25 mg, again the remaining 25 mg will get crossed. Again this 25 mg, in this 25 mg again 50% of the drug get crossed. So 12.5 mg and 12.5 mg. So this 12.5 mg should distribute to all the organs. So after that, again this 12.5 mg again should start absorbing into the biological membrane again until equilibrium is attained. So in this process, the complete amount of the drug gets absorbed through the biological membrane and distributes entirely in all the organs. Next, greater the area and lesser the thickness. So greater the area and lesser the thickness of the membrane, I have told you, if the surface area is increasing, the thickness will be decreased. For example, if you take any of the sheet or balloon, if you stretch it, what will happen? The thickness of the balloon will be reduced. Here also, if the area is extending, means what will happen? The thickness will be decreased. If the thickness is decreasing, means there will be a rapid absorption. When compared to the higher thickness, the thinner part can absorb the molecules very rapidly. Next, I have told you equilibrium is attained when the concentration on the either side of the membrane is equal. If the equilibrium is attained, there will be no chance of absorption of the drug from the outer side of the membrane. drugs which can exist in both ionized and unionized forms approach equilibrium primarily by the transfer of unionized species. I have told you passive diffusion is also called as non-ionic diffusion. So when compared with the ionized form and unionized form, unionized form is having a greater absorption capacity when compared to the ionized form of the drugs. If it want to attain equilibrium, the ionized form will be in the outer membrane, outer of the gastric fluids only. Only the unionized form get cross the biological membrane, and by transfer of unionized molecules only, it will attain the equilibrium concentration. And next, greater the membrane or water partition coefficient of the drug, faster the absorption. I have told you, if it is having a good and capable partition coefficient, it is having a greater absorption rate. Next, a lipophilic drug diffuses at a faster rate by solubilizing in the lipid layer of the membrane. If the drug is not only the lipophilic characteristics, but a drug should follow both the hydrophilic and lipophilic characteristics. If the drug is only oil soluble, it cannot dissolve. It is a rate limiting. The dissolution is a rate limiting step for the oil soluble drugs, and the permeation of the membrane is a rate limiting step for the hydrophilic drug. So any drug should have both the lipophilic and hydrophilic characteristics, then only it can dissolve rapidly and cross the membrane rapidly and show the best therapeutic effects. The drug diffuses rapidly when the volume of gastrointestinal fluids decreases the drug concentration in these fluids and lower the concentration gradient. So generally, if the concentration of the gastrointestinal fluids is low, what will happen? The drug will get diffuses rapidly, but it is most probably used in the case of overdosing or in the case of poisoning. So, since under usual conditions, this DK, M by W and H are kept constants. So, these are all replaced with the constant P. So, under usual abnormal conditions only, the values get changed. If is the drug absorption isn't rapid on usual conditions, DK, M by W were kept constant. And all these terms together, we are keeping P. So, this is the equation. So, in the place of that, we are taking P as a constant value. So, what do you mean by permeability? Permeability means nothing but penetration of the drug across the biological membrane. So, permeability refers to with ease with which a drug can penetrate or diffuse through a membrane rapidly. So, if the permeation is greater, dissolution is greater, then the drug can cross the biological membrane and can dissolve in the fluids more actively and reaches the good therapeutic effects. So, under usual conditions, this DK, M by W by H are kept constants, and the equation, this previous equation get changed to this equation. So, this equation follows first order process, and the passive diffusion also first order kinetics, because depends on the concentration gradient only, our therapeutic effect is depending. So, obviously, zero order means it will not depends on any of the factors, but first order diffusion process mainly depends on the time and the concentration of the drug. So, this is about the passive diffusion. In the next class, we will discuss about what do you mean by sink conditions and non-sink conditions. Thank you.